answering some Shohin Bonsai questions about the propagation of Shohin Bonsai, the choice of pots, what kind of material we can use, and so on. So let's get started. Hi, and welcome to the Shohin edition of this special episode where we are celebrating the 20th anniversary of Bonsai Empire. It's a great achievement serving the community of bonsai lovers for such a long time, so a big congratulations from here. And we're celebrating this by answering some Shohin Bonsai questions about the propagation of Shohin Bonsai, the choice of pots, what kind of material we can use, and so on. So let's get started. First part of the question goes on the selection of species we can use for Shohin Bonsai. The most important thing is that the leaf size is small already. That will increase your chances of getting success when you are designing very small trees. It can be Cotonaster microphylla with very small leaves. It can also be coniferous trees, Shimpako junipers with a compact foliage, and different types of trees. Any kind of trees or shrubs that are already developing small, tight leaves or needles will be suitable for Shohin Bonsai. Different types of Japanese maples will be great for this too, but there also are a lot of variations between maples with very large leaves that you will not be able to squeeze down in size, no matter what kind of techniques you're using. So finding trees already suitable with small, compact foliage or needles will absolutely be the best choice for having success with designing small trees. The coarser the growth, the larger the tree. I have an example with a normal Chinese garden center juniper with a little bit of coarse growth, but also an interesting foliage color. So I decided to try it out as a Shohin, but I have to design it in a little bit more rough state than the Shimpako juniper or the Itoigama juniper, developed with very small and tight foliage and short internodes. That's the distance between each pair of leaves or set of needles. So avoid any trees with very large leaves because that will never fit with the small size of Shohin, and use these species for larger bonsai instead. The Chinese elm in front of me is a very good example of a tree also for beginners that will be valuable for Shohin Bonsai and even small marmoset-sized bonsai. These marmoset bonsai, bean bonsai, measures from the rim to the top of the tree less than 10 centimeters, where Shohin has a maximum size at around 20 centimeters from the rim of the pot to the top of the tree. The Itoigama juniper here has a dense foliage, and we are able to produce dense foliage clouds with time, where the normal Chinese juniper that I talked about seconds ago will have a little bit more coarse growth, and therefore the design between these two types of trees will differ. Also, the Cotonaster in the background here have a different kind of leaf size than the small microphylla. This is Cotonaster, both of them, but they have difference in the leaf size and in the coarseness and strength of the growth. Therefore, this one will have to be a little bit larger than the small one. Both variations of Cotonasters are changing their colors of leaves at this time, and they will be dropping their leaves during the dormancy period. But you can see a significant difference between the leaf size. This has nothing to do with the training of those, although you can minimize the leaf size of deciduous trees over time for most of them. But here we have two different types of trees with different leaf size, and therefore we choose them for different purposes. If you compare the small Trident maple here with this Acer palmatum, a Japanese maple, you will see how the internodes is much more dense and shorter at the small Shohin than at the larger bonsai. And that's one of the huge difference when you are growing bonsai, is to understand the difference between the structure of a large tree and a very small Shohin. Another way to find material or grow it yourself is You can either buy a pre-shaped bonsai. This was developed from a roughly shaped Unibrus Itoigawa, but you can also start from scratch with a tree like this field maple Acer campestre, grown in a coverlander pot. And as you can see, we have a trunk that was cut back and now it's setting new growth, and this growth will be the future branches and the future canopy of a tree in a Shohin size. So you can very cheaply get going with Shohin bonsai, and I hope you will, and use some native material that you are sure working with your climate. You can of course import or buy imported trees if you want that for your collection. So there's a lot of possibilities to get started with Shohin bonsai. A good method to develop a Shohin bonsai from a raw material is by cutting them back hard and not being afraid of that. Of course, you have to know the specimen you are talking about. This is a prunus, a cherry tree, and as you can see, it has been chopped here and here and here. Some huge branches have been cut off to get it down in size, in the Shohin size, and now it is setting new growth that will be the future of this tree. This is a way of getting material. This is a gift from a friend. It has been grown for years in a small pot at somewhat double the size of this pot, and I have reduced this and started over as a Shohin instead of a medium-sized tree. Especially when growing Shohin bonsai, this is a great method to achieve a good result. And it doesn't differ very much from the way we develop Shohin bonsai or bonsai in general when they are field grown or pot grown at a nursery. The small trident maple here is developed the same way. You can see the rest of the scars after these have been, the bigger branches have been chopped off, and they have just been used to develop a thick trunk and afterwards develop the fine ramification and branches. This is the same I'm doing here, just earlier in the process. We're sitting in the studio today because it is raining and a little bit stormy outside. And one of the things you have to take care about when growing Shohin bonsai is that they are easier damaged than big and huge and heavy bonsai that will not blow off the benches as easily as these small trees. You also need to take extra care of watering during the hot period of the summer, because these trees easily dries out in the summer heat because there's very little soil to hold the water. Therefore, I use a less coarse substrate for my Shohin bonsai, adding a little bit of organic soil to them to keep the water, and also adding some mosses on top of the soil during the summer period so they will not dry out as easily. So watering is a main issue on keeping Shohin bonsai alive, where larger bonsai with a bigger amount, a bigger volume of soil can keep the moist for longer time. Therefore, we also have to take care of protecting them from the sun and wind during the summer period. Now we are coming into winter, and storing these trees, avoid them freezing too much. They will tolerate a little bit of freezing, but the soil will be frozen in a few hours, and then they will not be able to drag up water. Therefore, winter storage is more important to take care of in colder locations than you might have in southern Italy, but up here in northern Europe you might experience a little bit of freezing during the winter. These winters are still pretty mild, so last year all the trees went stayed outside, or most of them, but just protected from very heavy rain so they were not soaking, and because that would cause the roots to rot. So taking care of Shohin bonsai is more difficult than when you are dealing with larger bonsai. But it is easy to prune them and taking care of them regarding styling, because you have a much more simple material and you can easily work on the tree for less than an hour and be finished with it. When you have to go through a very large bonsai, it can take at least a day or more to pinch a juniper, for example. This one I can do within 2 or 3 hours. And a large specimen of the same kind in the huge size, it would take me more than a day at least. So there's a lot of fun growing Shohin bonsai, but you also have to take a little bit more care of the daily routines when you are checking them for water and not neglecting them. Finding material for Shohin bonsai is very much easier than finding a huge bonsai with a massive trunk and interest to make a show-worthy tree. With Shohin bonsai, you need less to do the same and it goes quicker. It is easier to find a small tree in an ordinary garden nursery center and change it into something beautiful within a period of 3, 5, or 10 years at maximum. If you're growing anything from seed, it will of course take a much longer time, but think about how long time it will take to grow up a huge bonsai the size of 80 centimeters or so in height that needs a trunk to support that kind of size. Therefore, it's much easier to find a small material like this for a cheap price and develop your own trees. One of the fun things about Shohin bonsai too is the variation of trees suitable for Shohin bonsai. You can use all kinds of small shrubs, showing the beauty of the flowers in the spring and summer and berries during the winter time and autumn. You can use a lot of low shrubs from garden centers instead of going into the mountains and dig out a huge mugo pine, for example. So it's one of the reasons I fancy Shohin bonsai. I like larger bonsai as well, but it's much easier and much more playful to play with Shohin bonsai for my taste. When it comes to pot selection, it doesn't differ that much from normal bonsai or larger bonsai. The only thing you have to think about is that have to be a variation of pots when you're doing a Shohin bonsai display. The Shohin bonsai display is different from the normal bonsai display that just shows a single large and impressive tree. Here we work with several trees, all showing the mood of the seasonal approach, and within the display with 2 or more trees, we want to have a variation of pots to make it more interesting. Usually for coniferous trees, it will be unglazed, earthy tone pots, and for deciduous trees and flowering trees, we're using colored glazed pots. That is not a rule, but a tradition, and it makes the display more interesting, and often the colored pots will underline the seasonal mood of these softer trees, like the Crotonaster when it shows flowers or berries. The earthy tones underline the strength of the coniferous trees, and therefore we are using these for selected species that are showing the strength of the trees. And digging into the Shohin display and how they are displayed is a really deep subject, will take a lot of time to explain. But if we should keep it short, it's just about showing a landscape feeling and the approach of the season when we are displaying the trees. All of the trees have to be in top shape and have almost the same size of trees, but that is more a tradition than a rule, and I have been recently experimenting with a different type of display using a different type of racks, and I can show you that while I'm talking about that. Trying to make it a little bit more interesting, a little bit more modern, so we evolve the way we are displaying bonsai. Some people cling to the traditions. I have a tendency to do that as well, but it is also fun to try to change things a little and make a different expression. But the Shohin display is about a group of trees expressing the landscape feeling, while the bonsai shows one single tree in a setting of a landscape. One of the huge differences, of course the size is a big difference, but one of the huge differences between bonsai, traditional bonsai and Shohin bonsai is the way we display them. We use different kinds of pots for Shohin bonsai because they can be more colorful than at a large bonsai. If you have a colored pot like this in a big size, it will be much too disturbing, but in the smaller size and when set up with several other trees, with other colors to tone it down, it will work quite differently. The big or huge difference between the Shohin Bonsai and Bonsai Display is that the Bonsai Display is about expressing the beauty of one single tree and where it is placed in the landscape. With Shohin Bonsai, it is much about a landscape feeling, a seasonal approach, using coniferous trees to show the strength of nature, and flowering or fruit-bearing or deciduous trees with faded colors to make an impression of the seasonal approach. That's a big difference, and we use several trees in a Shohin display, depending on the size, to express that mood of the season. It is also a landscape feeling we're trying to achieve, and therefore it's important what kind of trees are set together, what kind of movement do they have, how do they interact. Like at the small display in the background, where I'm just using two trees and a scroll to approach a seasonal feeling or a mood if you want to. There also is a big difference if it is in a tokonoma, a private setting like this, or for a bonsai show, but that's a very huge subject to begin with now. So this was a short introduction to Shohin Bonsai, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope it answered some of the questions coming in. Congratulations to Bonsai Empire with the 20th anniversary, and thank you for watching this.